This is A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. Today we are going to talk about the central dogma, and it's not only the central dogma, it's the central dogma of biology. So it's a really big deal, and it's actually broken up into two different parts, and there's part one, which is transcription, and there's part two, that's translation. So this video is about transcription. The first question we got to answer, though, is what is the central dogma? Why is this so important? One thing that I just want to start off with would be another name for the central dogma is protein synthesis. Because what we're going to be doing in this process is we're going to be taking your valuable DNA and we're going to be changing it into proteins. I keep on saying that your DNA is the blueprint for a living organism. And if I have a blueprint or a layout or the instructions to make a $2 million mansion, I don't actually have that $2 million mansion. I have the instructions to make it. However, I need the materials and I need workers to make the house. So DNA is just the blueprint. The central dogma of protein synthesis is going to actually be making the house or making the organism. So this is going to take place inside of a cell. And this occurs any time when an organism needs protein or cells. And the reason why we need to do this is because proteins are the building blocks for life. On the image on the right here, you see just a really nice picture, and that's a great summary of the central dogma, because we're going to go from DNA to transcription, which gives us RNA, and then RNA to protein, and that process is called translation. So like I said, there's two different processes here in the central dogma, which is making DNA into protein. So we gotta take two steps. The first step is transcription, and that is making an RNA strand from DNA. And then the second step is going to be translation, and that's going to be making a protein from the RNA strand that we made in transcription. Today's video, though, is going to be focused on transcription only. So we're only going to look at transcription, making an RNA strand from a DNA strand. So the what, the when, the where, and the why of transcription. First off, what is transcription? It is making mRNA from a DNA strand. So we're going to take DNA, we're going to unwind it, and we're going to make an RNA strand. And RNA is just single-stranded. When is this going to happen? It's going to happen after we unzip the DNA. It's going to take place in the nucleus. And the why, if you are taking notes right now, could you please star or square or highlight the why? The why is really important because the DNA is essentially trapped inside of a prison, and this prison is the nucleus. So the DNA cannot leave the nucleus at all. However, we need to use the DNA to make proteins. Ribosomes make proteins, and those ribosomes are in the cytoplasm. So we have a little bit of a problem here because the DNA is trapped in the nucleus, ribosomes make proteins in the cytoplasm, and the DNA is not going to be able to get to the ribosomes. So that is why we need this process. That's why this is so important, transcription. Because the DNA is going to send a message via the RNA. So it's going to send a copy of itself out into the cytoplasm. So what is mRNA? mRNA really, it stands for messenger RNA, and it truly is a message just like you send a text message to your friends or an email, because you're taking information from one place, the nucleus, and sending it to the cytoplasm. And we are doing this because, like I said, the DNA is trapped inside the nucleus. So mRNA is just a message that we're going to send out. So we did the who, well, kind of the what, the when, the where, the why. My final question is how. How are we going to make an mRNA strand from a DNA? So really the how is just with two enzymes. And the two enzymes that we're going to use are RNA helicase, which unzips the DNA, and RNA polymerase, which is going to add new letters onto the RNA strand. So it's going to make a new RNA strand by adding A, C, G, U. And that's shown here in this picture, but I also show it here in this picture where I'm drawing this out a little more. Just a reminder too, I'm not really explaining that much about RNA. You should go back and read the notes or watch the video on RNA where I describe the three differences. So this image here shows RNA happening, the production of it, with two things. Number one, we are unzipping the DNA strand. So the black is the DNA, and we're going to unzip it with RNA helicase. And then number two is going to be RNA polymerase. And that's going down the DNA strand, the DNA template, and it's reading the letters and adding new RNA letters to the RNA strand. So then what we're going to get at in the end is a nice new RNA strand that reads UUAGCCA. So the practice that I want you to do right now is I'll do this first one with you, and then you have two practice problems on your note sheet, but I want you to make an mRNA strand from a DNA. So I want you to do the transcription. So I'm going to do this first one here, and then you have two on your practice sheet. So once I'm done with this, go in and pause the video. But this is what this would look like. mRNA into from DNA to mRNA, you start U, A, G, C, U, G, C. So remember in RNA, there are no T's. The T's are replaced with U. So A is now going to go to U, and C and G still go together. So go ahead and pause the video, try the two on your practice sheet, and then unpause it to see if you got it right. Welcome back. Here are the correct answers for your practice. Hopefully you're doing these right. These are the mRNA strands that you should have generated. And like I said, you're the one that's doing transcription right now because you're taking DNA and making it into RNA. So wrapping things up here, number one, what did we do? Like, what was the whole purpose of this video? The whole purpose of the video was to show you that we make mRNA, messenger RNA, from DNA. And then the next question is, where do we go from here? What's going to happen from here is that mRNA is going to be sent out into the cytoplasm, and it's going to find ribosomes. And those ribosomes are going to take the RNA, and they are going to turn the RNA into protein. But that's in the next step. That step is called translation, and that's going to be just tied with another video. So that is all I have for today. Thank you for watching A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. I'm signing off.